Everybody, it's me, Cyber War. How my favorite people doing? I'm at Area 18. And I'm about to get in my whole seat, and we're gonna go do some. Cargo hauling. Yeah, we're gonna be trucking today. Trucking in the big rigs. What do you think, huh? All right, let's go make some money. I'm gonna show you guys, my favorite route. I usually make about 850 to 900,000 on this round trip. There's three spots, three pickups, three drop-offs. So, it's gonna be fun. First stop, after we leave Area 18 is to go to Bajini upstairs. And we're gonna load up there on processed food. Do not call your hull C out at a space station. The docking arms on the docking ports are broken. You will not be able to get into them. Hopefully it's fixed in 323. I have yet to hear if it is or not, but I know they're working on the docking ports right now, and they're putting in the hangers at the ports so you can store cargo and stuff in the docking port from your hull C's. So we'll see how that works. I'm not sure how they have that planned out to work, but for now, do not store your ship at a space station. Do not call your ship out at a space station. You can dock there if you're not going to store your ship. If you're just going to get off and get back on, that's okay. We're storing and calling our ships at ground-based spaceports. So Lorville, Area 18, and New Babbage. Do not call them out at Orison. They will stick you on a docking arm, and then you'll be really screwed. You can call it out at Grim Hex if you so desire. Why you'd want to go there is beyond me, but hey, you play your way, I play mine. But here at Bajini, we're just picking up a whole load of processed food. We should invest like 700,000. We'll make like 281,000 in profit after we sell it, depending on the market. Once we get close, just hit N, hold N down, and it'll auto dock for you. You gotta be not too close, but not too far. You do it a couple times and you will figure out kind of what the good distance is. As long as you're basically lined up on that plane and the doors are pretty much lined up, you can hit auto dock and it'll finish the last few meters for you. All right, I close my door before I leave. So this is gonna cost 700,000. Actually not that bad. Like I said, we're gonna make like 281,000 on that 700,000 investment. Now we gotta go get loaded. Turn on the engines. Call the station. You are clear to launch. Hold down N for a couple seconds, and the station should kick you out. There we go. Took a little longer than normal. Maybe this server is having issues, but get away from that port as soon as possible.
Thank you. And please visit again.
Might tell you are trespassing. Normally when you get released from the arm, the docking arm, it will tell you, it'll call the cargo deck automatically if you have cargo waiting. Sometimes you have to keep calling them and calling and hanging up and calling them, hanging up and calling them from the work. And then it gives you the little box area where you need to go and stop the ship and get ready to get loaded. Loading takes about 5 minutes. You're pretty well protected over here. There's a lot of guns around. If someone does come and interfere with your loading thing, it'll give them a warning that they're either going to get trespassed, and then the guns will light up on them. All right, so the dispatcher tells me to get in the position. Once I get in position, I stop moving. I'm in the loading area. I've stopped moving. It takes a second or two for them to register that. Because right now, there we go.
Cargo is being transferred.
Simple as that. Don't move your ship. If you want, you can turn your engines off. I leave my engines on. Just in case I gotta run. If you leave the area, you will forfeit your cargo. So be aware, you don't want to move. So there's still a lot of work for this to be done. They just needed to get it into game, start testing out the very fundamental basics of it before they start expanding upon behaviors and procedures. But this whole loop here has a whole lot of growth going on to it, hopefully over the next year. We're kind of just waiting on the server mesh and better AI behaviors for crews. When that'll be coming, I don't know, but we need AI crews pretty soon.
All cargo's being transferred.
All right, we're out of here. So we're gonna head over to Hurston, go to Everest Harbor. God, I can't wait for the new map. This ship has way different flight characteristics when it's extended. I put a super fast quantum drive into this thing. Since we travel long distances and it has a huge fuel tank, I'm not worried about fuel. Quantum fuel is really cheap. I'd rather get there quicker. All right, we're back. I had to log off real quick, but I'm back at it. We have a visual glitch, obviously, on the spindles. I'll get that fixed up as soon as I get unloaded here. Comma rate is down here. I don't like that. All right, we're gonna pull into Everest. We're gonna dock. We're gonna run in, sell our cargo, and then go get it unloaded.
Oh yes, you're looking for the cargo terminal.
All right, so we're gonna make about 282,000. It'll just say processing order and keep spinning. By the time you get back to your ship and everything, it should have gone through, and they'll give you a cargo assignment. Station's going after someone out there. Great. There is just a ton of weaponry over here. If that guy even tries to come over here. Looks like he got taken out. Nice. All right, we're almost done with our transfer. I'm going to close up the spindles once I'm done and go back inside and get ready for the second part of load up. All right, now that we're unloaded, we are going to go back in and load up.
So this is our costliest load of the day. It's 1.4 million for iron to load up. We're going to fly this out to the Terra Gateway, and we're going to sell it there and hopefully make around 260,000. We'll see when we get there.
Cargo transfer complete. All right, so we're gonna take this over to Terra.
Okay, fine. We'll do this the hard way.
Landing complete.
This is usually the place where I grab food and drink on my trip because I don't feel stressed out here and worried about being attacked so as much as the other areas. So I'm not really in a rush. All right, so I got 1.6. What do we pay? It was 1.4, right? Yeah. Yeah, so we were going to make like 200 and some thousand here. Let me open my my calculator. So we're making 258,048 credits. All right, we're gonna head back in. We're gonna load up.
Thank you, and please visit again.
Let's see what my total is right now. 0.68. All right. I think of what I started at 8.1. So made half a million already.
All right, time to go fill up again. I actually went out to lunch and I parked the ship and went to sleep in the bed after I unloaded. But I'm back, ready to do the final leg of this round trip. My wonderful daughter took me out for lunch for my birthday. And then I realized my now adult daughter just took her old man out for lunch. First time ever. She's only 18, but yeah, she bought me dinner, or lunch, I should say. It was awesome. It's like one of those hysterical moments in her life. Took her daddy out, picked up the bill. I'm expecting to make well over $300,000 on this return run hauling hydrogen. $524,000. All right, we gotta go pick it up now. Right, calling the cargo deck. Let's hope they give us an assignment. They're not picking up. I'm gonna hang up on them. Try again. All right, cargo transfer requested. Waiting your arrival. They didn't run the audio clip for some reason, but it's such a cool ship. I can't wait till they get this whole super large hauling cargo profession fleshed out. But like the placeholder for it right now, you know, it's still pretty cool. It's just they're gonna expand on it a lot. Assuming they have huge plans for it, if we're gonna see them around everywhere. All in cargo from place to place. Especially when like player bases and stuff happen. People will be running cargo and hull A's and all kinds of ships out to those bases. We're back at Bajini, where we started this little adventure. I'm going to dock the ship. I'm going to run in and sell it.
Landing complete. Have a pleasant stay.
The cargo terminal over there is probably what you're looking for.
All right, we spent $524,000 for it, and we're selling for $863,000. So it's what, 340, almost 340,000.
So over there.
Price has fluctuated a little. Normally it's like 350,000, but hey, I'll take it. So we probably made
for cargo stuff,
about 875,000 credits, give or take, which, you know, ain't too bad, you know. There's, you know, can you make more money doing more? Yeah, but you also have to invest a lot more on the hull C. And you don't, you know, you could go do other things and make money. But like if your main motivation in this game is just to make credits, you're missing out on so much, man. For me, hauling in the hull C is all about the experience. The loading, the unloading, the flying, the big old super ship. You know, you can haul other things in the ship too. You know, there's other routes. I'm just saying, this is my favorite. I go full circle. I leave my home port and I go back to my home port. And I make 875 to 900,000 on the trip. Takes about an hour. You know, just doing the one trip to begin with would pay for most of your upgrades on the ship. But like for me, this game, making credits is not really my main motivation. It's just not.
There's so much more to this game than making credits. Yeah, so just don't forget to always call and store your whole C at a ground base station. Do not store it or call it out at the space stations until they get the docking arms fixed. Always be vigilant. Set up security cameras in your whole C. That really helps so you don't have to sweep the ship all the time. You can lock the cockpit door if you want. Have a good time. It's all it is, you know? Make a little bit of money. Enjoy the scenery. Enjoy where you go. Go to other stations that have the cargo decks, which are all basically just the planetary spaceports, the gateways, and see what else you can buy. You know, you can run stuff from Magnus to Terra, and then the Terra to Arcorp, and whatever. Then back out to Magnus. There's all kinds of routes you can figure out. All right, good old Area 18. All right, I want to thank everyone for hanging out. If you haven't done so yet, hit the subscribe button. Give me a thumbs up. If you want to support the content creation of the channel, you can become a channel member for as little as $1.99 a month or as much as $4.99 a month. Gives you access to cool little perks, emojis, priority responses from me, early access to new videos, and behind-the-scenes stuff. And when I start streaming here, I'll be streaming on YouTube. You'll get even more perks with the streams, and just haven't had a chance to get the streaming set up for YouTube how I want it anyway. I'm kind of taking a break from streaming, but I'm looking to get back into it, so I might be doing it here a little bit, at least once a week, and then maybe on Twitch again too. But I'm having a lot of fun just making YouTube videos, so I'll be here. I ain't going anywhere. I appreciate you guys. I love you guys. I'm out. Cyber War signing off. You guys have a wonderful day out in the verse. I'm going to give you guys a salute here before I go. Da-da-da-da. All right. I'll see you guys later.